So, all of you watching this video right now, tuning in for the deep dark secrets, okay, from the elite corners of the military, the stuff the government doesn't want to tell you about. How many of you have had to look for your keys within the last week? Okay. Last 24 hours for some of you. Last month, all right? If not your keys, how about your wallets? Or how about your phone? How many of you have had to look for your phone? Or perhaps look for that pair of shoes or that shirt you wanted to wear? Or look for that file or that piece of paper you wrote something down on? Yeah, I'm gonna help you stop having to do that in this video if you listen up and pay attention and action what I say. I'm Paul from Apex Mindset. Take your finger over, slide it to the subscribe button, hit subscribe, hit the notification bell, because I don't always do my videos at the same time, so this will tell you when I'm doing them. And hit the like button if you like this stuff. So people liked my video last week I did on product, you know, it was a bit on how to be more productive and set up that environment and condition for your success. And there are tips that I gained from different areas of the military. And then people feel good about, you know, being told that it's in the elite corners of the military, you know, and all that stuff. Reality is, though, any combat arms, it's all combat arms. It's all infantry, just different forms of it, different levels of expertise, you know, different specialties. But it's all infantry and it's all basic. OK, so that's the reality of it. All right. Just so happens that some Navy SEAL team is going to do the basics way better than, you know, the average, you know, team in the conventional forces. But it's all the same things. It's just a matter of execution. But these little tips I'm giving you on how to be more productive and set up your conditions for success, these are going to be the same across the board. That's one thing that's good that our military has done very well, is they've set up those conditions for everybody to be successful. So if we can apply those to your life, you know, then you can be successful too in completing whatever your mission is, okay? So we'll get right down to it. This is a very simple tip, and you're going to think, why are you wasting your time and my time and your time on a video for this? But it's so simple that people overlook it. Basically, put your shit back. That's it. Put your shit back. Put it back. Put it back where it goes. It goes in a place. Figure out where the place is, and you put it back there. Okay, now, that sounds really simple, but think about it for a second, okay? You guys don't have designated places for things. You probably have too much crap also. So these are two things that hinder your ability to put it back. But if you put your stuff back in the same place every time, then you're never looking for things. Think about how amazing that would be to never have to look for anything and never lose anything. Think of how much time most of you listening to this video waste looking for your crap because you just can't find it. And think of what that does. Here's what it does, though. It doesn't just waste your time. It wastes your mental resources. You only have, because your discipline and willpower is directed by neurochemicals. You only have a certain amount of neurochemical supply as well as receptor capability a day. You only have a certain amount every single day, and then it gets tired, okay? It gets harder to do things, harder to discipline yourself, harder to get things done. And it gets to a point where you just don't want to/can't, all right? So most of you guys waste your willpower and discipline chemicals on dumb things, like looking for your keys, or I can't find this, can't find that. Now, what's funny about this is I used to be that guy. It's been a while now, at least over a year anyway. It took me a while to transfer these skills from the military environment to my civilian environment. And they're just skills, but they're habits. Okay, so these are habits you need to develop. But when I started living my life differently, you know, a few years ago, I rarely lose stuff, like not like most people. I'm not looking for things. And I've been in both places. I've been in the place where I've lost a key or a phone or something and found it again, of course, but like every single day. All right. There's just clutter. There's too much stuff. I don't put things back in the same place every time. And then I'm always looking for things. I mean, I've been in that place and I hate it. I'll never go back now that I'm in a new place where I'm never looking for anything. The amount of time, energy, and focus and just mental focus I wasted doing that and always looking for things is incredible. So this will, I'm telling you, this will 10x your ability to complete your life's mission. And this is a military tip, because in the military, starting in basic training, you have an SOP where how you do your locker, how you do your rucksack, where you put your stuff, where your shoes go. And then you're never looking for anything again. Okay. Because a drill sergeant says you got, 2 minutes to change your clothes and grab your stuff, and everyone run, or you're getting smoked. Everybody runs in and they know where their crap is and they grab it right away. Now, this applies on missions too. Do you think that they lose this skill when they get to Special Forces Group or Navy SEAL teams? No, they don't, okay? So even when I set up my kit, right? My ballistic vest with my magazines and my pouches, my stuff goes in the same place every time. So when I have to access it, I can access it very quickly. I'm not looking for stuff out in the field. That can mean death, all right? So good NCOs, non-commissioned officers, will train their guys to put their, they'll have an SOP for where all your stuff goes, okay? So even with my, but even down to my ballistic kit, okay, if I'm changing a magazine, I'm going to the same place every time to grab that mag. And then I have other magazines around on my vest, and then I replace, it's called my go-to mag place, I replace that magazine in that one place. So when I have to change a magazine on the fly, it's going to the same place every single time, mag change, drop pouch, and then, you know, when I have that opportunity in the fight, I manage my workspace, which is placing that magazine back into the go-to mag place. So if I'm out in the field in a fight, have a place for my go-to magazine, and then I'm managing my workspace in the middle of a fight, then that means you need to have a place for all your stuff, and you need to manage your workspace in your productive environment. It just makes sense, all right? The simplest thing, quickest thing is going to work in the dire situation, okay, where you don't have time to think. Well, let's remove wasting your mental energy on thinking about where you put stuff. And so it's just a really simple concept. So like, let's see if I can do this. I'll turn this around. Okay, there's a beautiful view of the lake and all that stuff. And now we're just gonna look. Okay, look. Here's the stuff I carry with me just about every day. I got my selection of sunglasses over here. I got one of these pistols, keys, wallet, whatever. Okay, here's, I select whatever watch I'm going to wear, or a piece of jewelry, and that's it. But see how it's just laid out? Okay, that's pretty simple. And so I'm never looking for, I'm never looking for my keys. My keys go there. I get into my place and I go to my office. I drop my keys. It's that simple, drop my keys, my wallet, all my stuff goes there. My phone, I'm actually using to film because I got to figure out how to use my new camera, but my phone would go there, or my phone would actually go on my desk in a place I have right here on my desk. I don't have clutter. I'm minimalist, so I don't have a bunch of stuff everywhere, and I just put my stuff where it goes every single time. So when I get in the door now, if for some reason I'm not going to come all the way up to my office, it's the second story, I have a place in the kitchen area for where my keys will go. So that's my secondary place. All right. Where any of those things, those items you see there, might go there. And it's a designated place. It doesn't go anywhere else. So my keys don't end up on top of the microwave, in a pile of clutter, underneath some clothes somewhere, on top of the TV. You see, get what I'm saying? My phone doesn't end up somewhere in the bathroom, end up somewhere else. It's either on me or it's in one of these two places. And that's it. End of story. There is no other option. And so reduce your options, make a place for everything, reduce the amount of clutter you have, and then just put it in the same place every time. So if you're listening to this video, you've made it to the 10-minute mark, good job. Here's an assignment for you, all right? Figure out a place for your stuff that you use every day, okay? Figure out a place for your stuff that you know, that you're gonna need to access for being productive, achieving your goal, and put it in the same place every time and start practicing that, and do it for the next 4 weeks, all right? It's gonna take a lot of effort. They say 21 days to create a habit. That's minimal, sometimes a little bit longer, but you know, put that effort into doing this, okay? Now, this will lead to some secondary tasks too. So if you got a bunch of clutter and a bunch of crap, then it's gonna be hard to, you know, have that space for you. You know what I mean? So start removing your crap, removing your clutter. That's something you can do too. But minimally next month, just start putting your stuff away. Just put your shit away. Put it in the same place every time. That's it. Now, once you start it with your main things that you utilize every day, now that will you can start transferring that skill set into other things. So you can get to be almost 100% organized after a while, after practicing this habit, where you put your shit away and it all goes into place. Like, so you're just never looking for anything. And let me tell you, your life will be so much better. It's really hard to show up and be that alpha guy or that calm, happy, non-anxious person when your shit is everywhere and you're constantly looking for it. It's really hard to show up and be that person. You know what I mean? So if you want to be, and it's hard to enjoy your life. It's hard to enjoy things because you're constantly frazzled. You're late. You're constant state of where's my shit, all right? So this is a simple tip. This is a tip that starts with a basic training soldier who's gonna do the most non-combat thing you can think of up into the most elite soldiers in the world that are doing crazy combat stuff, okay? Everybody from that spectrum learns the skill set right away. All right. So teach yourself this skill set right away. Apply it right away. Right now, apply it. This video is over. When you're done liking it and telling everybody how awesome it is, you know, and sharing it with all your friends, go start actioning this. All right.